Good morning, you guys. Everybody just ignore the pimple that I have on my nose. It's been there for 2 weeks. And I'm trying to be patient with it. Burst down, Tatiana. I want to see you burst down. So today, in this vlog, we just do all the cute New York things. And I want to do those things with you guys right now because we're about to go through a huge transition phase together. Right now, it's just this vlog is going to be so New York. The next vlog will be so LA, quite literally. And then when I get back from LA, we have August, which I am going to be figuring out how I'm going to be decorating this apartment. Victoria is literally going to take everything with her to LA, leaving this place looking like a trap house. I know that there's a couple of things that I really want to get, some furniture that I really want to get installed and get put in, but all the good furniture is kind of on back order. So I am going to be doing things the way that I do best, which is doing things the antique way. Facebook Marketplace, finding those huge merino glass mirrors. I just want this place to be very, very like witchy mid-century renaissance. That's my whole vibe. I want to put those together. Victoria's kind of more of a maximalist. I'm a lot more of a minimalist when it comes to aesthetic. So I'm super excited to just see how I do it. $50,000 later. Anyways, I will let you guys enjoy this vlog. So first off, we're gonna go shopping because that's just my favorite thing to do first. So we're gonna do that first.
Are you ready? Are you ready? If you ain't got no money, take your broke ass home, you say.
If you ain't got no money, take your broke ass home.
L-A-M-O-R-O-U-S, yeah. Flying first class, up in the sky, popping champagne, living my life in the fast lane. I won't change by the glamorous, ooh, flowers and flowers and
bone.
So we just went shopping and now we're headed back home and we're gonna go to a jazz club tonight. I'm very, very excited about it. Normalize being outside this summer, but we gotta normalize doing it in a very mature and obscure way. Also, y'all are always like, oh, why don't you ever tell us like where you got this top from? Why don't you ever tell us where you got this top from, this stuff from? This is why. That is why. Yeah, I can already hear the oh's. Yeah. Unplugging the AC. Ooh. It is the next day and I am sitting in bed watching old French films right now. I'm currently watching The Beauty and the Beast, the 1946 version, and it is so beautiful. But I wanted to come here to say this really quickly because I feel like Something that I'm really lucky and blessed is that I feel like you guys really understand me. You see right through me. Granted, I'm pretty authentic. And I feel like we have a very trustworthy, like, relationship. You know, I think about it a lot when I think about what kind of deals I do, what kind of products I'm promoting, what I'm doing. And I say all that to say, if you ever see me wild out in the comments, like 2014 Rihanna on Twitter style, just know I had a good reason. Because there's a lot of things that I feel like that happened that I just don't have the time to explain. I deal with a lot of crazy, transphobic, threatening comments around the clock all day long. It's not like it doesn't really affect me because I feel like I've been dealing with it all my life. But there are some times that I feel like I kind of wanna, you know, bite back. So if you guys ever do see me bite back in the comment section, just know it was within good reason. You know, I feel like I choose to be loving and compassionate, but at the end of the day, I'm a Congolese woman through and through who happened to grow up as a gutter bitch in the South. I am not above letting a bitch know that they're beneath me if they need to know that. It's concealed information that I keep locked in my Virgo rising box. No one needs to know that shit. I will let you live your happy-go-lucky life. I don't give a fuck what your beliefs are. But if you come knocking at my door acting fucking crazy, I'm gonna get you right. Oh yeah, I'm gonna get you right. No, also, the other thing is, bitches be saying so much shit about me on the online. You don't ever really see it. You might always see my comments being super positive because I filter all of them. I'm a psycho. Like, why does nobody know this? Talk shit about me online all you fucking want. At the end of the day, I am 6 foot tall. I'm 6'1", as a matter of fact. We are not doing this. Like, we are definitely not doing this. Cause I will sit on your ass. I will dead ass sit on you. Back to Beauty and the Beast. Okay, so.
Hi.
Wait, I'm gonna introduce you. So, I'm in the car. Right now, I'm here. My girl Gabby's in town. Give us space. Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, is this? We're wearing matching skirts.
Yes, Kenzo skirts.
It's gonna be super fun. Hopefully, it's gonna be open bar. So, who gives
a fuck? It's gonna be open bar. Do you think I'll go to a party? Am I the type of girl to go to a party that's not open bar?
Hell no.
New York City is about having an open bar.
New York City is all about.
You go to a bar and you say, "Is this an open bar?" And they say yes.
We also have the Yui sunglasses on right now, and I feel like
you look hot.
They just take me up. Like, so kind. Super kind. So one reason why I love Gabby, you guys, is because Gabby is like so incredibly niche. Anything that you think is like niche,
I'm just indie. I'm not like the other girls.
So not like the other bitches. We're just having a conversation about how she's in a phase in her life where she has an abundance of friends who bake cakes.
Follow Maddie at Frosted Hag.
Frosted Hag.
And Tired Hag on her Instagram. She's hot and she makes hot cakes.
So kind.
She's so beautiful. My crush.
I'm trying to.
Actually, I should hit her up. Oh, we're here.
We are here.
Yeah, it do not matter. Turn to a savage, pocket got fatter. She call me daddy. Smoking that gas, girl, I designed it, she on a powder. Nowadays, I am on my head, I got sadder. Money got longer, speaker got louder, car got faster. Turned to a savage, pocket got fatter, she call me daddy. Smoking that gas, girl, I designed it, she on a powder. Nowadays, I am on my head, I got sadder. Money got longer, speaker got louder, car got faster.
Let's all go!
Sorry, I get really aggressive. But I'm excited.
I'm about to give y'all hoes something that y'all, I'm not even sure if y'all are deserving of this for real, but I'm feeling very spontaneous right now.
I look so ran through. The fact that, like, I look ran through, but my skin is still giving, like, that's crazy. But I look so ran through.
Hello, vlog. It is Thursday afternoon. It's 4:15 right now. This vlog will be out in 45 minutes. I have a little tequila something, some Casamigos. I'm starting a little bit early right now. So I feel kind of bad because I feel like this past vlog, the one that I just filmed, was kind of ass. I was just really busy. You guys are always asking for longer content. There will be longer content, I promise you. The next video is going to be me going to LA. The next two videos will be all filmed in LA. There'll be so many things for you guys to watch. But I think right now what I wanna give you is the how I got here. Let's just get into it. So, the how I got here. I'm trying to do this like rapid fire because I'm trying to keep this under 12 minutes. I grew up in North Carolina. I started working in the music industry when I was 15 years old. I started working in event management. Hold on, I fucking hate New York. So I started working in event management when I was 15 years old. We started throwing shows for underground artists, and it was me and my business partner and a couple of our friends. And first it was just underground SoundCloud music artists, and then it pushed us to artists that were up and coming, like Lil Peep and Team Sash, Xavier Wolf, and then we started doing like Bryson Tiller, Future, Chance the Rapper, all with the help and the cradling of Live Nation. Also, yes, I know, I am backlit. I don't have time to refilm that again. If you would just close your eyes and listen to the sound of my voice. And then after, oh my God. After that, I kind of took a break from music, and then I took a year off from school when I graduated high school. Then I started trying to learn and studying how to run my own business. I got back into the music industry when I was probably 21 years old, and then I started managing music artists. It was specifically talent management, but still event management. It was based out in South Korea. So I kind of, while I was doing that, I started finding the importance of audience and social media marketing. And because we were in the music industry, we were promoting music, I started to stumble across TikTok influencers. And then I started to think to myself that I could do just this. I could build my own audience. I can't fucking stand working in the music industry. It makes me so angry. It's so shiesty. And so I decided to start making my own videos and building my own platform. And then when I was 22, I decided that I wanted to move to New York City. At the time when I decided to move to New York City, I was only working 3 jobs. And then I started working 5 jobs. And saving all of my money, it was like a crazy like year for me. I'm African, so like working hard is so ingrained in our culture. I think I'm always gonna wanna work hard. So I worked 5 jobs, saved my money, moved to New York City, moved into an apartment in the Lower East Side with 2 girls that I met off of TikTok. We ended up hitting it off and becoming like sisters. And I just sort of worked my ass off. Before, like, it was like during the pandemic still. So, you know, no one knows this about me, but I used to work Postmates, DoorDash, and Uber Eats all on foot in the winter in New York when it would snow, when it would rain. I would be on foot delivering food so I could make money. And I was making videos on TikTok and using the Creator Fund to make money. And I was working at 5 a.m. until, 5 a.m. until
12:30 p.m., 1 p.m. at some coffee shop in Brooklyn. And then I started doing astrology readings on my TikTok. And I opened a separate source because I was getting so many views. I opened a separate source for me to be able to do readings and make money. I think I was getting at least 60,000 views per video, at least, at the very least. So I was like, okay, let me just start doing personal private readings. And I opened it up. You guys were so amazing. I think I was like making like $5,000 or $6,000 a video from readings alone. And then I got my first brand deal for Paper Mag and DKNY. And it was enough money secure that I knew I could pay rent and buy food and be cool away from working jobs. And so I went full in with TikTok, and then I was doing my readings. Eventually I stopped doing my readings because I got so many brand deals. And now I am building my brand through influencing full time. It's influencing, content creation. When I go out to LA, you guys will see me. I'm filming my first video podcast TV show with Brat TV and Picture Start. I'm super excited about it. I will tell you that I literally moved to New York City with $2,500 and a fucking dream. I was literally broke as fuck. And yeah. I made it work. I'm very tough. When I want something, I make it happen. And you know, I was fortunate enough to grow up with parents who were immigrants, and just seeing how hard they worked to be able to create a life of security for my sisters and I really inspired me to be somebody who is really resilient. Also growing up being first generation, being femme, being trans, being outed as gay when I was super young, being bullied all my life, all those things sort of led me to be somebody who could silence out the rest of the world long enough to really just focus in on what I wanted and then choose to make every single choice that I made after that an opportunity for me to get to where I am now. I mean, obviously I'm a workaholic, and I have really, really huge dreams. I never stop thinking about them. I'm always thinking about what I can do next. And I'm really excited that I am where I am now, especially only being 24. But I do have a lot of other things planned and a lot of other things coming. And this is just the beginning. I know I've probably seemed pretty stressed out. It's just that I have a nail appointment in like an hour. And my friend's birthday is literally right after, and I have to run and go get him a present, and then go to my nail appointment, come back, get changed, then go to his birthday, and I only have one day to spend with my best friend tomorrow. She's coming back, Victoria's coming back tomorrow, and I'm spending one day with her, and then I go to LA. So that is why I'm like this. But that is all for now, vlog. That was an 8-minute clip that I'm gonna have to now edit. Fuck my life. I love you hoes. I love you bitches. Good night.